From CNBC Global Headquarters, this is On the Money.
It is a night of records, and records are meant to be broken. The Dow and Google both with eye-popping numbers tonight. First, Google blows past street estimates with amazing earnings. The global search king posting numbers that have Wall Street and investors stunned. And that must also stun Yahoo and the rest of the online world. Tonight, there is Google and everyone else. We begin with our Jim Goldman live in San Jose. Jim?
Yeah, you know, this company beat the whisper number by better than 30 cents a share. CEO Eric Schmidt says Google is, quote, ecstatic about the performance, strong in the U.S., even stronger overseas. And coming just 2 days after Yahoo's disappointing results, Google's performance is that much sweeter for its investors. Google swings for the fences and the ball smashes a windshield in the parking lot. The company crushing the $3.30 consensus by a staggering 38 cents.
I definitely think this is a good time to commit capital to Google.
At the same time, Google adds another 1,600 workers. That's 200 more than the street expected, and still managed to beat the street on profit margins. Growing this fast, better than 60%, but not sacrificing profits to do it.
The growth rate so far has been in the 60s, and I think going forward, we're going to experience just a little bit less growth than what we've seen so far, but that's kind of due to the law of large numbers.
Google's at kind of a financial crossroads where, for the first time in the company's history, drama outside the company's earnings seemed to be gaining more urgency. The increasingly contentious billion-dollar copyright suit filed by Viacom.
When Google acquired YouTube, they set aside a pretty significant amount of money to cover copyright liability. So they weren't innocents going into the party.
Viacom, you're either doing a business deal with them or being sued by them. We started the former, and then we ended up with the latter.
The antitrust concerns behind Google's planned $3 billion DoubleClick merger.
We literally jumped at the chance to talk to DoubleClick about becoming part of Google.
And whether the company's massive ongoing research and development spending will actually yield some kind of return on those investments and create some new revenue streams.
We, the markets, will see that ROI over the course of this year. We think the stock is trading at a very attractive multiple point now.
Making Google the best deal for investors right now, he says, compared to other big net names like Yahoo, eBay, and Amazon.
We think the risk-reward on Google right here is the most attractive.
As long as the company can keep performing and with an earnings report like this one, there's no reason to think otherwise, at least not yet. And even with today's rally, you compare this company's PE to rival Yahoo's, and Google is by far the cheaper stock and still growing at a far faster clip. Google eating Yahoo's lunch and sticking it with a tab. Melissa, back to you.
All right, our tech master, Jim, thanks so much. Let's get right to our Google insiders. Owen Thomas, online editor for Business 2.0, CNBC contributor Paul Kodrowski, Vishesh Kumar, senior writer for TheStreet.com, and Mark Mahaney, internet research director for Citigroup. Mark, let me start with you. What's your reaction to Google's numbers?
Well, this would be considered a clean beat and raise quarter, except they don't give guidance, but it was a clean beat quarter, perhaps about 5% clean bottom line beat, international real strength there. And people were nervous about margins going in. They got a nice positive margin surprise. So people are going to be happy with the results.
Vishesh, what do you think? I mean, it looks like a blowout quarter. I saw a little bit of chatter online, you know, some people saying, well, this is what they expected. What do you think?
Absolutely. It was a great quarter, but the fact is that they beat the estimates by 11.5% this time. They beat them about 8% each time for the last two quarters and 12% before that. So investor expectations have come to expect a lot from this company.
So they're not expecting the expectation, in other words, is what you're saying. Owen, what do you think?
Well, I think what you really notice in the earnings call is that they're not talking about any of their new businesses. In fact, Eric Schmidt said that he really wanted the company to focus on its marketing, its search and advertising business, which is very successful. But there ain't anything new under the sun here, was my takeaway.
Really? Paul, what do you think about that?
Yeah, you know, but there's nothing new, but that's a good thing.
Yeah.
I mean, I go along with Owen on this, is that I don't actually want anything new. I mean, the blessing and the curse of Google is that they're levered to a single market, but it's a heck of a great market. And so, you know, distractions right now aren't necessarily that great.
Yeah. One number that stood out to me, number of searches for February alone were up 40% versus a year ago. Can anyone catch them? Paul, what do you think?
No, I mean, this is one of these tippy markets where the further you are out in front, the further you stay in front, because, you know, in a sense, Google becomes a verb. It's this default option for people who are doing searches. You just can't escape it.
Yeah, Owen, what do you think about that?
Well, you know, Google is growing very fast, but if you were to look at Yahoo just by itself in isolation, that company is growing very nicely. It's doing more searches. I mean, everyone is doing more searches. It's a growing market as advertising shifts online, no question. So, you know, Google, of course, makes everyone look like pikers by comparison.
Well, Mark, let's talk about Google versus Yahoo, because what about the stock? This is something that Jim and I were talking about before the show started. I mean, Google is trading at 25 times forward earnings. It seems like a deal compared to Yahoo that's trading at 37 times forward earnings. What do you think?
You know, that's true. Those relative numbers are roughly right. You know, what we really like Google, though, is, look, you buy it 25 times earnings for that. You're really just paying for a search engine, the leader in the search engine market. And we think there's a lot of option value on top of that. We don't think Google stops with search. Google will make money in display advertising and revenue off the Internet. And you get all that essentially for free because you're just paying for search. That's why it's our favorite stock.
Vishesh, what do you think about that? Is it a deal right now?
Well, it's been a deal for quite some time, and there's a risk that it's going to become even more of a deal. I mean, we're entering a slow season in the summer. It's always had a more attractive valuation than Yahoo. It's always gained more market share month over month for the foreseeable past. So the question is, what's going to get investors to start buying this stuff?
You know, though, I'm going to play a little bit contrarian on this and say, you know, Google, while it's sort of priced, you know, a little bit more compellingly on a relative level, you think about triggers for driving stocks higher. I think people kind of overdid the Yahoo thing. Panama just rolled out in the quarter. There's a lot of room for levering much higher CPMs over the CPCs over the next three quarters. There's lots of room. Hey, say SemmelWeeks, that'd be a happy day. There's a lot of things that can trigger Yahoo higher, and it gets really underestimated here.
All right. Well, but in addition to faster sales growth, Google made more money per search than Yahoo. That's another stat. I mean, what does Google get that Terry Semel is missing, do you think?
Well, I think what's going on here is that Yahoo just really put in a Google-like system for its ads.
Right.
And it's not enough to upgrade the software. You need to get more data. You keep iterating. You get better and better as you watch people search. And Yahoo has just started to take advantage of that.
And that's going to happen much faster. The sooner that, you know, Terry Semel finds something else to do is my take. So,
Mark, what do you think about that? Are you a Terry Semel hater as well?
No, don't put me in that category.
No?
I agree with Paul. I think Yahoo shares have oversold, but they have some problems they need to address outside of search. If those stabilize, Yahoo can certainly work very well from here. Not as well as Google, but there's no reason Yahoo shouldn't work well if they can work out their display advertising business.
And one of the bigger surprises on the Yahoo quarter was how surprised people inside the company were. I heard from a lot of people all over the company who had been given every indication this was going to be a much more positive quarter. And so, you know, this comes back to a lot of communication issues. There's better stuff going on. It's just not getting communicated.
Mark, but wait a second. Were you going to defend Terry Semel there? Because we're on Terry Semel watch here. Kramer has him at the top of his hit list. I mean, were you going to defend him?
Go, Jim.
Look, let's put it in context. Terry came in 6 years ago and has turned this company. This stock has quadrupled under his watch. So, yes, we've had a lot of problems in the last year. But let's not forget the previous, you know, 5 years. This person deserves a lot of credit. There are some execution problems now, communication problems, and he certainly bears his responsibility for
that.
Should
he stay?
Management changes are probably a good thing.
Oh, so you think he should go. You just don't think that we should hang him out to dry the way we have been.
Well,
okay.
Don't hang him out to dry. Absolutely
I think Yahoo's
not.
Problems might go well beyond Terry Semel at this point. I mean, this is a decade-old company, and I don't think it's commonly appreciated how far ahead Google is going in terms of its ability to hone in on search.
A lot of it, though, is that Google gets that what it's really providing is an advertising operating system. Yahoo thinks it's still in the business of social media, and they're wrong.
Yeah. So, Owen, let's get back to that. I mean, how can Google stay ahead of its competitors the way it is? They're buying up things left and right, pumping out different products. Is that a smart move?
You know what? Google is not that young company either. They really have to deal with some internal confusion about whether they're building new Google products or just features for existing products like search.
What should they be doing?
You see today's announcement with Frugal. You know, they turned that into Google Product Search. Aside from Gmail, it's hard to think of a new product that Google has come out with that's just been a runaway hit.
How essential is it that they have a new product? I mean, it seems like they're doing pretty well.
Yeah, it's not. I just think that's it. I mean, I actually get frustrated the more new products I see from them. I think, you know, it's all about the focus. Let investors diversify. This is a great levered play on a growing ad market.
Mark, what do you think?
I think there's one big category they're just starting to tap into now. That's display advertising on the internet. Look, that's 40% of all internet ad dollars. So they're starting to get at it with YouTube. They're going to definitely get at it with DoubleClick. If they have half the level of success in display advertising that they've had in search, there's upside to numbers. There's upside to the stock.
Mark, did your expectations change for the rest of the year with the numbers that you heard today?
We're working through that, but you would think that there'd be an upward bias given the upside to the numbers.
Vishesh, what about you? I mean, they keep, as we say, they keep beating by so much. Do expectations just get higher and higher? How about yours?
Yeah, absolutely. The expectations continue to get higher, and they're doing well financially, but the stock is still where it was about a year ago. And to Paul's point, I mean, in this business, if you're not moving forward, you're kind of falling behind. And seeing as the big play here is going to be selling advertising across a number of mediums,
absolutely.
I think they're going to have to show some real traction in some of those other markets to remain competitive in their core market in the long run.
Which is DoubleClick, right? I mean, which is kind of a blessing and a curse, right? The blessing is that DoubleClick brings them into CPM ads. The curse is that it's a huge overhang. No one knows how the acquisition is going to play out. And frankly, I think they've been overly murky about the numbers from DoubleClick as well.
All right, gentlemen, we're going to leave it there. Thanks so much for joining us. Well, one amazing story down. Many more to come right here on The Money.